it is a general reading, this may or may not resonate. Okay, if it doesn't, check out your other placements. If you need a personal reading, all that information is going to be below.
All right, looks like there's quite a final breakup from your side. I feel like, you know what, you were living in illusions all this while, Gemini. You know, you were probably in this, you know how we say that illusion that everything's okay in your connection and things will be okay, right? I think that's what you were doing. You were living in your head all this while. The entire relationship was built in your head all this while, okay? And you thought that everything was gonna be okay, or you just thought that it was just a part of the game. It was just a waiting game and you guys will eventually get back to each other, okay? But I think you needed something drastic, and that's what's going on. This time you're having a very drastic approach towards the person you're dealing with, and this person out here tried to move on from you. They tried to look what's on the other side, where the grass is green on the other side here, but they just couldn't find the emotional strength to walk away from you. They can't move on from you. They can't move on, okay? And you, on the other hand here, I feel that... you're ready to build this connection? No, I don't think you're ready to build this connection. I think you're okay to be on your own. I think you're letting this connection go. This is definitely a breakup separation, but this is more like a, this is more like, how do I say this? You're maturing. You're learning your lessons, but to learn your lessons, you have to go through some emotional loss. Okay, and now you're maturing, and I think you're moving more towards spirituality. You've gained the wisdom, you've learned your lessons from this connection, you've paid a price, okay? And now you're becoming more spiritual, and now you're just ready to let this connection go. Whilst this person out here is wanting to come back towards you, okay? That's what I'm getting here. See, the Fool in reverse, they don't want to take the risk. This is a very reckless person, very impulsive person. You know, they will make decisions so impulsively, like they won't think twice before cutting communication or cutting a connection or before just, you know, doing anything. They don't think twice, okay? Very quick decision maker. This person needs to think more, okay? I'm not saying that this person needs to wait and watch. It's more like they can make a decision, but the decision needs to be a more well-thought decision, or take more calculated risks. Either this person does not take risks at all, or they're just like too, like I said, reckless. Okay. See, Ten of Pentacles in reverse. You thought this was a very stable and a very secure, committed relationship, but now you realize that it wasn't. Okay. I think you're no longer waiting for this person to come towards you or to commit to you. I think this is all you wanted, because you reached a point of this connection where it was like the end, okay? More than the end, it was, you could have had a chance to start something brand new with this person. Like, you know what I'm saying, right? Like from a scale to 1 to 10, right? This person and you were like 1 to 9. That's where you reached. The only thing that was missing was a commitment. But now you realize that this commitment is probably either never happening, or you don't want this with this person anymore. Because this person is too back and forth, you know, very on and off with their connection. They know there is an opportunity to start something brand new with you, but they refuse to take that leap of faith. They refuse to take that risk because they think your risky business or this connection is... Nine of Swords. Yeah, see, this person has a habit of making mountain out of molehill. You know, this person suffers in silence. You know, they usually overthink, overanalyze situations. Okay, they think too much in their head, which is why they don't take action. That's a massive overthinker out here. All right. Of course, this person does have a lot of arrogance. They have a lot of attitude. A lot of pride is what I'm getting here, where they think that they've done the right thing all this while, only to realize deep within, you know, that they didn't. Okay, so I feel this person has a lot of remorse, regret. They're thinking about you day and night, wanting to come back towards you, but they don't have the balls to take the action. Okay, they don't have the balls to take that risk as yet here. But yeah, they're suffering a lot of sleepless nights, stress, anxiety, worry, you know, negative thinking. Oh, it's all over, it's never going to be able to come back again, etc. Okay, but they haven't moved on from you. Six of Cups, you miss them. You miss them, Gemini. I think you know this person is your soulmate, or you feel a strong soulmate connection to this person. You do miss them. You do have the best of memories with them, okay? Maybe you would want to give this person a chance, okay, to salvage the relationship. But I feel this is what you wanted. You wanted commitment. You wanted peace, harmony. You wanted to be, you wanted something more tangible, okay? This person could have always been very emotionally detached, okay? Or this person, for them, emotions or really making a relationship work out was not as important as a career or something else, okay? And now they regret what they did with you. But you miss them. You probably even want them to come back, or you want them to call you, text you. But I think you have a lot of reminiscing, okay, about the memories that you had with them. But again, you know, I don't feel like you're okay with them coming back or you want them back. I just feel like it's that sweet memories. You just miss them. You're looking back at the past. It's like, oh, those were good times. You know, I wish we could have had something more, you know, or I wish we could have done it better. Okay. Yeah. They had their guards up. This person had their guards up, you know. They refused to learn their lessons. That's what's happening here. This person anyways does not allow, you know, this person had trust issues, okay. And they pushed you away, you know. They sabotaged the connection. They pushed you away. You know what happens is in this kind of energy, yes, you keep your guards up because you want to keep your enemies away, right? What they do is, in pushing away the enemies, in doubting every person that comes towards them or any person that they have a relationship with them, you know, probably because in their mind, they probably think that you may hurt them or you may, whatever, screw them over if they are ready to be vulnerable towards you, right? So in order, in doing that, right, due to past issues, whatever, they could have had a bad past, you push away the ones that are even good for you, okay? That's what they did. They pushed away a relationship that was good for them, and now they're ready to let their guards down. They're ready to let their guards down. And you're walking away. You're walking away. Because you don't want to be lonely in this relationship forever. You don't want to be lonely in this relationship forever. You know? You feel very isolated, very left out, very abandoned, very lonely. What's the point of being in a relationship or a connection where it's you're the only one there, right? You're doing all the work and you're the one who's just constantly trying to text, constantly trying to make the first move, constantly trying to make the relationship work out, right? Again, you have the best of memories with them, but again, nothing's changing in this relationship is what I'm getting here. You know, in this scenario, it's like you don't see any other choice but to walk away. All right, what action does this person plan on taking towards you? And what action do you plan on taking? So you love this person, I feel. You, okay, you're emotionally still balanced here. Okay, I feel you're staying emotionally balanced out here. But I don't think you're taking any action. I think earlier you were very imbalanced. I think earlier you were very vulnerable, or earlier you could have had trust issues, okay? But I think now you're trying to focus. You're trying to, you're mastering your emotions is what I'm getting here, okay? And by mastering your emotions, you probably are trying to stay... you know, you're having your head and heart in place, okay? This person out here, right, with the temperance out here, I feel this person is also trying to do the same thing here. With the temperance here, I feel this person is trying to calm down after the storm here. This person is trying to find a resolution, but, this person definitely wants a reconciliation with you. See, you're not even looking at them, okay? It's like, you know what? You realize you were in a path where things were very rocky, etc. You know, you lost your cool. You lost your shit a lot of times. You overdid your emotions, whatever it is, right? But now you have control over them. This person out here is also trying. They make you wait. They're making you wait, okay? They're making you wait in a good way. Why I like this is because this is someone who's just not trying to be impulsive anymore. That's what I'm taking. These people out here earlier, they were very thrill lovers, okay? This person could be a thrill lover, okay? This person could be a risk taker. This person could be someone, you know, like because of... they have a lot of... they're very enthusiastic, you know? But what happens is that self-confidence, right, becomes arrogant sometimes, ego sometimes, okay? Which sometimes makes them very, very emotional and sometimes very aggressive. And then they face a lot of regrets, okay? So I think now they're trying to work on their emotional and mental stability. They're trying to stay more balanced out here. Okay, they're trying to bring in a more positive influence in their life. Okay, they're trying to be kind and caring and trying to be on the same wavelength, on a very higher vibration. Let's see the outcome. Yeah, this person's going to come out of isolation and they're going to come and talk to you. They want to have a very peaceful communication with you, and this person will talk to you, okay? If this person is on a break, I feel for a lot of you, most of you are in no communication. This person will finally talk. They will finally talk. They will come out of isolation. They finally know what they want. They've taken the break. They've taken the resting period that they wanted. They've healed, and they're ready to come towards you wanting a reconciliation, and they will offer you a commitment. Commitment, I'm not saying this is a proper commitment, but this definitely could be an emotional commitment. This could be a love offer. This could be some kind of emotional communication, but not really the immature one like the Page of Cups. But it could be an apology, but there's definitely someone who's ready to open up, ready to be vulnerable, ready to sweep your 58. I feel this person is ready to tell you everything that they haven't. They've kept you at par all this while. Now they're ready to let their guards down, okay? They have a lot of regrets that they pushed you away. They pushed a good connection away. And now they're ready to do it, you know, the right way. You are going to have a little drastic approach towards this person. I feel when this person comes in, right, Gemini, this time you're not going to be living in your head. This time you're going to be like watching things the way it is, okay? It's like you're going to be so much more realistic, practical, and say rigid, you know, in the way you approach this person or in the way you entertain this person. It's not even funny. You're no longer approaching this in a very emotional way. You miss them, but that's about it. That's about it. Because you probably realized that this was all a part of your head games, a part of your illusion, where you thought everything was okay, everything was going to be okay. In fact, you just realized it's not. Okay. And when this person comes towards you, I don't know. I have a feeling you may not really react as such or take any action. Maybe you'll just hear them out. But they're coming towards you, and I guess this is going to be an end of no communication for you guys. They're ready to talk to you. Okay. So I hope this reading resonates, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.